Welcome back, folks, to Pokemon Why. My name is Josh Jepson, but you knew that already. And this is Tierno. And he's telling me about Pokemarts and where I can buy Pokeballs, so that's fun. And what are you? You are telling me that I can change. So like I said in the last episode, you can actually change your clothing in this game, and I think that we have stuff already unlocked, but it's not a lot. And nothing I really care about. I don't like my hat, though, or my glasses. Can I just take that off? Yeah, cool. I was not a big fan of just the glasses. Can I take off my bag, too? No. Just the glasses. Can I take off my shoes and just walk around in my socks all day long? Which you can actually change, believe it or not. Anyway, no, I want to change. This is fun. Look at me, look at how sexy I am now. So in the previous episode, we made our way to Santaloon City through the forest, and we actually caught a Pikachu. We caught a Pikachu in the last episode, I believe. So, oh hey, speaking of clothing, let's go shopping, folks. I love shopping, it's my favorite. If you'd like, check out the items at the back of the shop. What do you have? A knit cap? You have hats. I actually kind of like this hat. I don't want the button, though. I'll take the hat. I believe this is actually the one that my character wears in my Pokemon game. I will change. Can I do that? I want to completely change. I don't want to just fit. I want to change to my logo cap, which I own. Oh, yeah. Now I look way cooler. Now if I only had like a black jacket, that would be cool. You'll see me change from time to time in the game, you never know. I'm not gonna ever do that on screen ever again though, but I mean, part of doing a Let's Play is showing stuff off, right? Speaking of showing stuff off, I'ma sit on this bench. What, son? What, son? You can sit on benches. Okay, I'm done with that now. I believe Santaloon City has a gym, and I'm gonna go and challenge it. I don't know if I'm ready for that yet, actually, now that I think about it, because I didn't do any training in between episodes just yet, but I'm fairly certain that I'll be able to beat the first gym on what I've got after fighting all the gym trainers and stuff. I don't think I'm gonna have to do any grinding for a while. In fact, actually, I might not have to do any grinding at all, and I'll explain why as when we get the item that we're gonna get. But basically, there's an item that basically it renders you completely, like, it renders grinding completely useless, which is good, but it also makes the game really easy. Hello. Oh, this isn't the gym. This is the Pokemon school. Well, I've got all kinds of items now. Does anyone ever use X Attack and X Defense and all those, like X Speed and stuff like that? Because I remember getting them and not, like, understanding how to use them when I was younger. And I get how they work now, but I still don't use them. I feel like it's a waste of a turn to just up your speed or whatever, but I guess it ups it by a lot, so. And in the right situations, it can be a good boost. Like, I saw this one video with this Japanese guy dominated somebody with, or dominated the Elite Four with just a level 1 Magikarp. Or not a level 1 Magikarp, it was just a Magikarp. I think it was level 100, but it was a Magikarp anyway. It might have been a level 1 Magikarp. That would have been really impressive. It was like hatched from an egg or something. Except that I think it was Gen 3, so I don't think hatching Pokemon from eggs gave you level 1 Pokemon in that game yet. Anyway, I don't know. Trainer School. Cool. Where is the gym? Not there. Ah, here we go. Hello. Hey, stranger, isn't cruising around town in your roller skates just the best thing ever? Wait, do you mean to tell me that you don't even own a pair of roller skates? Then how about this? If you beat me in a Pokemon battle, I'll give you a pair. I could never say no to a contest, not me. So how about it? Do you want a battle? Yeah, why not? I have no choice, really, because you're kind of blocking the entrance to the gym. Rinka. What kind of name is Rinka, anyway? And why do you have a Zigzagoon? A single Zigzagoon. That's not gonna... You're not gonna defend yourself at all doing that. All right, goodbye, Zigzagoon. It was nice knowing you, pal. Well, not really. I don't like you, Zigzagoon. Of all of the, like, the first... Like, the first starting Pokemon of any generation, like, Rattata, Pidgey, Zigzagoon, and, like, all the different bird Pokemon, I think Zigzagoon is probably the most useless, because Linoon isn't much better when it evolves. At least the other Pokemon have some sort of leg to stand on a little bit, especially Pidgey. Pidgey is, like, I should have caught that first Pidgey that I found in the wild. That's what I should have done. That's how good Pidgey is. Actually, all the bird Pokemon are pretty decent. Now that I think about it, actually, Fletchling is really good in this game, too, because I'm pretty sure it evolves into a Pokemon that's part Fire-type. It's Flying Fire-type, I'm pretty sure. I could be wrong about that, though, so don't quote me on that. I don't know my types or even, like, the names of the Pokemon that well in this generation, but, I mean, playing it again, I'll probably get them a little bit better. Roller Skates, a.k.a. the most weird... way to move around this game possible. Goodbye. You just run into the wall. Whee! I actually really like the roller skates. I know some people aren't a fan of them, but I really like them. You can do certain tricks with them too. I don't think I've actually unlocked tricks yet. Oh yeah, I can do a spin. You can basically do any tricks from the beginning of the game. There's actually some people in the game that teach you how to do tricks, though. All right, I would definitely like to go inside the gym instead of walking into the wall, please. This is cool. So the gym leader of this gym is a photographer. Specifically, she likes to take pictures of bug Pokemon. Nectar's Siren Song Photographer, Viola. Yours photographs are currently being displayed in the gallery. It's a Metapod to be evolved. All right. What's up, dude? What can you tell me about the gym? What's the hustle, little Crustle? Welcome to Santaloon City Gym. So, future champ, this will be your first time challenging the gym, huh? Are you thrilled? Are you pumped? You should be. No worries here. You've got Pokemon on your side. And really, they're the ones who are going to be doing all the battling. Yeah, no, I'm not going to get into a fist fight with the gym leader, although that would be amazing if you could just have an option to do that. Like, go into a Pokemon battle with no Pokemon and just start beating, like, wailing on their Pokemon with your fists. Do you have, you don't have any potions or anything for me? What a joke. I'm never going to talk to you again. I don't like you anymore. So when I go into a gym, I usually fight all of the gym trainers. In fact, that's usually the theme of the game. I usually fight pretty much every trainer. That I lay eyes on, and that is going to be no exception for this Let's Play either. I'm going to fight every gym trainer, and the reason being is because you can't go back and fight gym trainers once you've completed the gym, so it's better to beat them now and get that experience than just leave it be or try to get past them, even though a lot of gyms will give you the option to get around certain gym trainers. Ledibar, you're going down. I'm really gonna have to train my Pikachu a little bit. My Froakie will probably do pretty okay in this dungeon, so long as they don't have any weird grass attacks. But I can't imagine that they would, being bug Pokemon. They probably just have all bug attacks, which isn't gonna really do a whole lot to my Froakie anyway. My Froakie should have Frubbles, like in the stupid-ass anime. Have you guys seen that yet? Have you seen any parts of the XY anime? Ash has a Froakie, and, like, the stuff around his neck apparently is Frubbles in the anime. Like, I don't know why they call him Frubbles. I guess Bubbles and Froakie combined. It's the dumbest thing I've ever heard. And it's, like, his standard attack, even though that's not a thing in this game. He's Bubble, but that's not Frubbles. It's stupid. I don't think they ever referenced that in the game, unless it's in his Pokedex entry, and I didn't realize it. But somehow I don't think so. I think it's just one of those dumb things that the anime made up. And it's just so stupid hearing him, like, use it in a serious tone. Like, Ash will call out an attack in battle, in a gym battle, and it'll be like, Froakie, use your Frubbles to make him die! And it's just, yeah, it's dumb. So this particular gym actually has these bubbles that will fall, and basically... it'll show you where you haven't been yet by dropping all the bubbles. So you know where you've been, because if there's no bubbles there, chances are you've been there. And if there's bubbles, chances are that's like the next pathway. Well, hello, little friend. You look familiar. You're a Spewp. What a weird Pokemon. I'm not going to attack you with Pikachu, although I do want Pikachu to grab some experience in this battle before the big fight with the gym leader. I definitely probably should have taken some time to train up my Pokemon a bit in between episodes, and I will be after this one, especially if I do poorly on the gym leader. But I should be pretty okay if I can get past the gym trainers. The way that I figure it, too, is there's not a lot of, a huge downside to actually just taking the hits and dying in a gym or in, like, the Elite Four, because I used to do that a lot in the older games. In the newer ones, you lose money for losing battles, but outside of that, you don't lose anything, and you keep all the experience. It would be one thing if you lose experience and money, because then you would have a real reason for restarting. But I never understood people that restart, like save before a gym leader and then restart. The only reason I save before a gym leader is because if something happens to my game during a battle and I run out of, like the battle ends up taking too long and I run out of time or something. All right, I need to go back. I don't think there are any more gym trainers, so. Oh, there's one more. Here, well, I'll just heal my Pokemon up while I'm here, and then I'll leave to go heal. Oh, excuse you. Can I use my... No, I was going to say, can I use my my newfound roller skates in this gym? Oh, I was definitely going to use potions on my Pokemon before this. Maybe I can beat her without using potions. Let's see. She only has a Kakuna, and possibly a Beedrill, maybe? Maybe she has two Kakunas. She has two Kakunas, I'm good. She ain't gonna kill me with Kakuna. Level 7 Kakuna, even. Thundershock him. Yeah, I got this. Poison Sting. If I don't get poisoned, I'll be good. And actually, if I get poisoned, I might be screwed. I might lose Pokemon because... Ah, you're paralyzed! Aha! Kakuna stands no match against my Thundershock. Oh. I'm a bit underwhelmed by the third party. I said that once before already. The spin-off Pokemon games this generation. There's not a lot of them. Pokemon Battle Trophy is probably my favorite one, though. I don't know why. I was just thinking about that. It's kind of a random, out-of-the-blue thing to say in the middle of a battle here, but... Combi, you are part flying. Sorry. Pikachu's all over that. Okay. All right. I had a momentary heart attack. Yeah! Alright. Now, I went down to the red there, and it started beeping at me. And I wanted to just bring this up really fast. Something that I thought was a really cool addition that they took away. In Generation 5, in Pokemon Black and White and Black and White 2, they introduced the near-death music, which I thought was one of the coolest things ever. The death turret is... I don't need that. I thought it was one of the coolest things ever because it was always, like, super annoying, like, doing the entire battle in red health or whatever and just have your Pokemon beeping at you all the time. It was a really annoying noise, but they remedied that by adding, like, a beat to it and have, like, it was kind of like a beat and there was music and stuff to it. I thought it was a really, really, really cool addition. That they just took away. Hopefully we'll see that back in like the remix or something. I think that would be really cool. I don't know why, but that was just one of my favorite parts about it. All right, so I'm gonna head back. There we go. I'm gonna head back, heal my Pokemon, and I'll return to the gym and fight our fair gym leader. And now, with my fully healed awesome Pokemon, I will take on Viola, the bug gym leader. I like how the bubbles just basically tell you where to go. It's super easy. I know where to go. I mean, it's easy anyway because it's just a pathway, really. There's no puzzle element to it. Hello, Viola. I have something special for you. It's called death. The determined expression. That glint in your eye that says you're up to the challenge. It's fantastic. Just fantastic. Is this your first time challenging a gym? Fantastic! Whether it's the tears of frustration that follow a loss or the blossoming of the joy that comes with victory. They're both great subjects for my camera. Fantastic! This'll just be fantastic! Now come at me! I bet you'd like that, wouldn't you? Girl, bring it on, woman. So cool. You are challenged by Leader Viola. God, I forgot how cool the intro to the gym leader battles is. And actually, the music's pretty cool, too. Surskit, I'm sorry to say, but you are part water type. And you are going downtown. You're upriver without a paddle, good sir. However, your water type Pokemon, so you'll be fine. You'll be fine eventually. After you get healed at the Pokemon Center, because you died. I'm sad that he used Quick Attack. If he used anything else, I would have killed him before he even got an attack in on me. Because I think he used, what did he use? Like, he made it rain, I think? I don't think it was Rain Dance, but it was something that he some sort of environmental effect or status-changing thing. Half the time, I ain't even paying attention. I'll keep battling. I don't think Vivillon is flying type. It's just bug type, but that's okay. Vivillon is an interesting Pokemon because, or Vivillon, I guess, is what it's pronounced. It's an interesting Pokemon because it has all kinds of different patterns. They actually have one that's coming out. I don't know when it's supposed to come out or where you can get it, but there's one that has a pattern on its wings that looks like a Pokeball, which I thought was really cool. And actually, apparently, it is part flying type because I'm doing super effective moves with my Thundershock. I am okay with this. I am very okay with this. What the heck? That's really morbid. Infestation? Gross, dude. Water support. Oh, it was water support that he used. That's okay. I'm gonna use. She used a potion! My Pikachu's gonna faint. I was hoping to get her and, like, end the battle before her infestation kills me. But infestation's probably gonna kill me here. Nope. Good. Perfect. I will be able to switch Pokemon, right? Unless, no, infestation keeps me from switching out, doesn't it? No, that's okay, I got plenty of potion. Good ol' potion. I don't have any super potion though. I always found it funny that in the anime, instead of saying I have super potions, it was like, I have super potion. I have enough super potion for all of these Pokemon. I don't know why. I just was amused by the lack of the plural. Like, the plural was one, which is weird. Anyway, one more freaking hit and you're a goner? One more hit and I'm a goner. So, I'm gonna take a risk. I'm gonna use Thundershock and hope she doesn't use... Good, she didn't use a potion. And gym leaders early on in this game do not have, super potions and full heals, like full revives, or what are they, full restores. I'm pretty sure that Pokemon, they have, like, gym leaders had full restores in the previous Pokemon games. Most of them, anyway, or super potions, at least. I'm pretty sure that, like, Roxanne, in Pokemon Ruby, Sapphire, and Emerald had super potions. Was the first freaking gym. Just fantastic. Look at how fantastic this fantastic gym badge is. I feel so freaking-tastic. And I got Infestation, which I don't probably plan on ever using because it's a bug-type move and I don't have any bug Pokemon. And I don't think I will have any bug Pokemon. Unless I get a Heracross, because I think Heracross is probably the coolest bug-type Pokemon out there. And Heracross has a Mega Evolution. So there's that. Now then, can you zoom in a bit and check out the tent behind me? Take the stage, find behind it, and you'll be back at the entrance faster than a flash. Thank you, Viola. I quite appreciate it. It's weird that you live in a tent in your gym, but that's, you know, your own prerogative. I'm not judging, mostly. Maybe a little. And now that we've done that, I do believe that means that we're ever so slightly more badass. Look at that. I bet that schmancy pants professor who gave you your first Pokemon would be amazed to see that. After you heal up your Pokemon in the Pokemon Center, why don't you head up to the Pokemon Lab in Lumiose City and show it to him? Okay, so Professor Sycamore apparently lives in Lumiose City. In the next episode, we're going to head up that way, I guess. And that's really our next goal. And I think there's a gym there, too. Whether or not I can challenge it right away, I don't think I can. But I've got one badge at least, so we'll heal up. And thank you guys for watching. If you like this video, please hit like. If you really like this video, consider subscribing to my YouTube channel if you haven't done that already. In the next episode, we'll continue to Lumiose City, and it will be good times. Join me for the next exciting edition of Pokemon Y.